I've always liked to get dirt under my fingernails. I've always wanted to be fearless, part of the greatest generation that wasted nothing, that made the best of what they had and never pointed out what they didn't. Thanks to my grandmother and her generation, I learned to cook with economy, with respect for simple ingredients. Thanks to her, I'm a modern pioneer, and I want that for you. Whether you're living on a rural homestead or sharing a studio apartment, modern pioneering is all about learning how to step off the grid in your own way, one that is uniquely yours. This is your guide for how to delight in the vegetables growing on your fire escape, to mark the seasons by the scents of the herbs growing on your windowsill, lit by the mason jar lanterns you've made with your own hands. It's not about survival, it's a way of life. We need to fill our hands with berries that we have picked ourselves. Only then do we feel truly full.
Guest is a talented chef who packs a shotgun along with her bag of knives.
If I ever made squirrel for you, you'd go bonkers.
Balsamic deer heart.
What's the taste difference between bison and beef?
So it's more tender.
Wow, I love that. Talk about a girl's night out.
Would you want to do that?
I'm there. Georgia, invite Carla and I.
I know, we want to go camping with you.
All right, girls, we're about to get our hands dirty.
It's a pioneering way to do something that you would probably normally throw out and turn into something wonderful and new. I'm gonna add a little bit of water. Now I'm gonna take some smaller flowers. I love using herbs.
Cast iron is one of my favorite cookware materials. The best part, you don't have to wash it. In fact, you shouldn't.
I'm more of a guerrilla gardener, so I take a lot of things from the wild, plants, herbs, and this is gonna be a little bit of a different phase. Now with an avocado, you don't wanna use plants that are gonna need a lot of water. You wanna use more woody herbs. Now for seeds, you could get creative here. I'm gonna use some wildflowers. I've got 2.5 cups. You're gonna start to feel it come together, almost like a good dough. This is a great activity to include your kids in. It helps them get their hands dirty and teaches them some guerrilla gardening.
Hey, look what I found. Lunch.
How about a little buttercup?
All women like flowers. I get it.
Today we're making lemon basil ice cream. It's my all-time favorite ice cream. You're gonna take those eggs and you're gonna separate the yolks from the whites, and you're gonna take 5 whole beautiful yolks.
I'm gonna make some Pinot Noir blueberry jam.
So we're making flour-studded ice cubes, and for me it's about having a little bit of whimsy in a party or in a cocktail. Mixology has become a big thing these days.
How about an untraditional spin on a traditionally sweet treat?
Using these little guys and a few other easy-to-find items, I'm gonna show you how to make a quick and easy beeswax candle. I'm so excited. We're here at South on Main in Little Rock, Arkansas, and we're about to go in and meet my friend, Chef Matt Bell. We're gonna learn to butcher some beef and learn about the cuts of ribeye. Let's go.
We're gonna pull this lip back.
You need to get a little muscle in there. You gotta work out to get, start butchering your meat. Just peels off like a stocking.
Yeah, right? Like a stocking. Absolutely.
I feel like all my metaphors,
yeah.
All my meat metaphors.
Except the dental metaphor. This is as fresh as it gets.
Cheers.
Cheers. It's the real thing.
It's like wine tasting, only different.
Mm. When was the last time you did something that was just for you, 100% just about you?
Never. I've never done anything just about me.
Cindy, honey. Cindy, we're about to change that. No more.
Lady knows what she's doing. She's like Annie Oakley meets Reese Witherspoon.
Ooh, she's pecking me. Raw meat.
Own life. Take on life with abandon.
Come on. Share. Sharing is caring.
And you put the gas on my adventurous spirit. Thank you for making a difference in my life.
Ah! Come on.